Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to UWE Lockdown, and this is the voice, Jack Thomas, signing in here live, and here comes Ustilo, the man that assaulted Jason Atlas last week, and one of the three contenders announced for the Trailer Park Brawl at Hell's Vacancy. And Ustilo certainly has had a change of heart throughout the past week, and now we get to hear why.
Oh, haven't I been here before? I come out here, I complain to you guys about how I lose and how I need the respect, and then what happens? Daisy comes out and kicks my head off, right? Except this time, Daisy's on his farewell tour, and I'm the more aggressive one here. Let me take you back a little bit about how I started here. I come in with some no-name, versing him one-on-one, and Adnan comes out, interrupts the both of us, and then what happens? It becomes a triple threat. That's great and everything, except the no-name doesn't show up, and then I'm a one-on-one with Adnan, and then the losing starts. I lose against Adnan. Lips, Daisy, Adnan again. And you know what? I'm sick and tired. And then, you know, just a couple weeks ago, I finally got my first victory against Bullet. Maybe it's not the victory I wanted, but I get the victory. And then we go in with a tag match, and we're strong, and we got it. Atlas and Ustilo, world on fire, doesn't matter. And then what happens? I get distracted. Atlas costs me the match. And then that's it. I'm back on loser's field. So you know what? I just found out I'm tired and sick and tired of being nice. I'm sick and tired. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm tired of it. So I attacked Atlas. Who gives a shit? He's just a little baby face, doesn't really matter. And so then Dirty comes and he interrupts. Like, what is up with that? You know, the year of the flame is here to stay, and the inner demon is here. So come on, Atlas. If you're out there, I don't give a shit. Come on.
Wow. Some aggressive words from Ustilo. Looks like our sensor guy in the truck took the week off. Ustilo has had a lot of pent up aggression. And here comes Jason Atlas, and you can see he is not in a very nice mood. Probably holding in a lot of anger and frustration after being stabbed in the back from Ustilo. And I can only imagine what Atlas wants to do right now to Ustilo. Look at that.
Well, if it isn't baby Atlas. You know, I always wanted to set the world on fire, or, you know, in this case, an Atlas. So what do you have to say?
Atlas looks speechless right now.
Yeah, exactly. You have nothing to say. You know why you have nothing to say? Because you cost us our match! I'm done with picking up after you. I'm done! We're trying to save you. I'll tell you when you're done. Triple threat match, no disqualification. I am gonna cut your fucking head off.
Wow. As you can see.
Oh, I like to see you try. Oh, it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen.
Uh-oh, this looks like it's gonna be a fight.
Oh, now it's yourself, look out, but Hugh Grave.
And here comes the third man. Just when you thought the tension couldn't be any thicker between these two individuals, here comes the UWE 2015 Superstar of the Year, the Gunslinger of the Underground, Dirty DeChico. This is going to be quite the confrontation, I can assure you that, amongst Ustilo, Atlas,
what do you want? You already interfered enough.
Wow. You sound so genuinely upset. I don't think I've ever pissed anybody off that much with just my presence. That's upsetting. Really.
It's because you had to interfere. I already had this little baby face on the ropes, and what happened? You had to turn it into a junkyard match.
Oh, no.
You have no idea what's coming.
DeChico! 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 DeChico!
You all right? Look over here. You can divert your eyes from me.
A lot of supporters for Dirty the Chico.
Yeah, I'm sorry that my interference is just such a complainable thing for you. I mean, why on earth would you feel the need to whine and complain constantly? But besides the point, you still don't seem to get it. You hate him, he hates you. That's hilarious. Because honestly, y'all are stupid as hell. You hate him because he hates somebody else. You hate him because he can't wrestle. Ouch. That's all right. You guys have the perfect opportunity to get rid of all that anger in there. It's gonna be hilarious. I love this shit.
You know what's gonna be hilarious?
What?
When I pin the guy that hired me. 1, 2, 3. Just like I took out the former CEO, Everett Creed. Mm. Only thing is,
it's not really that high on the list of accomplishments anymore, Atlas.
No, I guess it's really not. But it will be when I pin the superstar here.
Wow.
After busting his head open and making him taste his own blood.
I'd be careful because
nobody makes me bleed my own blood.
Nobody.
No, I'm kidding. Oh. The truth is that you seem to think you have a shot here. I got 6. 3 for you, 3 for him. I'll be all right.
Faster than you think.
When is it done? That was bear skin.
Oh! It's the Chico clobbering Atlas! The Chico taking it. Oh, wait, look at Ustilo! Oh my god, the scorched!
Oh, you didn't see that coming, did you now, Dirty?
Not really, no.
You know what?
I'm done here. Hit my music!
Oh boy.
Okay.
Looks like Ustilo got the last laugh, but. Where's his music?
Hit my music!
He wants it again!
Not cool enough.
Wow. Well!
Should be the biggest mistake of your life, boy!
We'll see!
This is gonna be quite an amazing, not even a match, but a fight that's gonna take place at Hell's Vacancy, our next UWE live spectacular. And the official theme song of this event is Go to Hell by Alice Cooper. But this trailer park brawl, guys, if you have ever seen a trailer park brawl with Dirty the Chico, you know exactly what is about to take place. And just remember what happened in the triple threat match at WrestleCon when the Chico fought Thomas Gray and Drew Hood. This right here is going to be an all-out brawl. Quite obviously, it's going to be a trailer park brawl.
All right. It all makes sense now. It all makes sense. 16. It all makes sense now. That day that I lost my championship because I had to vacate it because someone hit me with a car, had New York plates. It was heading south when it hit me. There was only one guy from New York that had just recently left, who then made a connection to drive down south and move on with his life. And then he was headed to Georgia. There's only one member of the underground. It was you. It was you, wasn't it? It had to have been you. There's no one else. There's no one else that could have possibly made all of those coincidences into one single situation. It was all you.
it had to have been this man who became this legend, who became this guy in one episode that went from down here to all the way up here. It was you. It had to have not been you. I knew it wasn't you. Damn it. Oh, you can't sneak up on me. You can't sneak up on me like that. Can't sneak up on me like that, okay?
What's your problem, man?
What's my problem? Well, first of all, come best in the yard too, you're my problem then. But right now, I got a bigger problem. I got a found out, I'm losing my grammar, my English here. Oh my god. I have to find out who ruined my VTW career. Ran me over? Made me lose the championship? All that? And, I was gonna think you did it. And everyone's betting their bottom dollar that you did it, but I found out it wasn't you.
Yeah, why would it be me?
It wasn't you.
Why would I get in a car to run you over when you know I want you 110 for best in the R2?
It's that logic, and I checked the footage over and over again. And you were peeking outside the curtain.
Yeah.
You watched me get run over.
Yeah, I wasn't gonna come save you, and yeah. I'd just be stupid. Well, I could've got one too.
That wouldn't have been logical.
But you know what, Mr. Hood? Best present.
Before we do this little toast, I need to say that while you did defeat this guy on lockdown, I'm gonna have to put him out for good.
I don't care.
So this guy, Fat Jack, Mr. Fat Jack, standing 6 foot tall, weighing 4,573,268 pounds. He is a one-time UWE world champion for less than 5 minutes because you beat him. Good job, by the way. REF helped you out there. He's the sponsor for Michelin Tires. Oh, Tyler. Oh, God. VTW in my head now.
Thinking about the people that try to bury you.
I'm trying to think. I'm thinking of VTW again. Oh, boy.
No, I thought you were thinking about CCW. Oh, sorry.
It's fine. I was there before. Now, Michelin Tire guy.
To cut that out.
He's very close. Very close. They look like twins. I heard Jack won 1,000 eating contests. He destroys weight scales. He takes 1 foot and breaks them. He's conquered all the holiday meals. Thanksgiving fears him. Christmas can't stand him. It's awful. And then I checked the stock market, and he's got stocks all up in Twinkies and other delicious treats.
What's that say?
Which part?
Stunt double for KBW's bulldozer.
Oh, God, they have the same problem. It's always the... Peppa Kid.
Well, Drew, Mr. Hood, it's good to see you again.
Yeah, decent to see you too.
And, best in the R2.
Close.
They're not just booing me, they're booing us.
Yeah.
And the reason being is because we're overrated.
Overrated.
Almost slipped up there. Almost had a big one in the truck, huh?
There you go. Yeah, we're overrated. Severely.
But, I'm gonna let you. Damn. That's the good stuff, and you. Don't read. Oh, God.
I'm sorry, Cam. Desperate times call for desperate measures.
Yeah,
and I gotta study up on my future opponent if he shows up for Hell's Vacancy.
Oh, and just jerk off to a cookbook. But, anyways.
Diablo wrote a home and garden. Did you hear about that?
Yeah, the news never went up. But anyways, I'm gonna go do what I do.
By the way, if you let Cousin Joe, Cousin Joe Cool, if you let him beat you for that world championship, we may have to reevaluate your career and my career. Because if he can win and I can't, then
Let me tell you something about your cousin Joe that you probably didn't know. He is the most underrated of the overrated. For 1 second, he can be all goofy, and the next second, he can take you out.
He suffers from multiple personality I shouldn't talk about that around you, I'm sorry. He suffers from certain mental things. It's not his fault. It's genetics.
But anyways, it's good that we can be civil. Because mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure every other feud for best in yards, everybody's going to beat the shit out of each other, just like they did on WrestleCon, Everett and Corey. Anyway,
Look, the thing is, we'll talk about our feud later.
But,
can't take up too much time with it.
Of course, we're only the main event. Anyways, Drew, Fat Jack, even though that board is full of comical remarks, every hit matters. It needs to be the same both ways. So, until then, you stay focused, stay classy, and stay 16.
Come on, Jack. You better come my way, Jack. I got a fist waiting for you. Just rip your face.
I think Drew Hood has gone quite a bit mad with the search of who found him down. The man that ran him over, that Fury. But the CJE World's Heavyweight Championship will be defended at Hell's Vacancy as Cameron Jackson, the reigning and defending champion, will face JHI's Joe Cool. Diablo, already the BTW World's Heavyweight Champion. And not to mention the success that D-Lock and Dustin Plague have if Joe Cool returns to BTW with our championship. JHI will continue to be perhaps and even, they'll be even greater than they are before. But here comes the prodigal knight, Revan. And Revan has been dealing with his own inner demons as of late. And it looks like Revan is going to discuss a very serious topic of the matter, because there's been a lot of controversy on Revan's disappearance from the UWE for the past 6 months. And now we're going to find out. I know there's been a lot of rumors, but I guess there's only one way to find out. And that's through the words of the mouth of Revan.
For a long time now, I have been angry, I guess you can call it.
Angry?
Not for the reasons you may think. Yes, I lost at Broken Glory to CJE and REF. Yes, I was cheated. Yes, he blinded me. Yes, I was cheated. However, that's not why I'm angry. I'll deal with that bug at another time. I have more pressing matters to deal with. You see, after a small bit of recovering, if you can't remember what happened a decent amount of time ago, let me refresh your memory.
I don't understand why this man would attack Revan like this, and this is just attacking right there, that blunt object to the back of...
See, I was attacked. So, I had to recuperate. I lost the opportunity to fight at Ultimate Redemption. I was gone for far too long.
Light years.
I had to spend a lot of time in the cold oil tank. The only benefit was that I got to spend time with the one person that matters to me most, my wife. It's the only good thing that came from this. But here's the thing. I had some friends of mine in the Republic do some digging around. You know, Republic Network spies and all that junk. I managed to find some pertinent clues and some very interesting information. You see, after so much time wasted on a bug like this, I found out who attacked me. It was none other than our residential hacker.
Oh, wait a minute. Well, I'll be damned. It was anonymous this whole time? Well, why? Why would Anonymous attack Revan and cost him 6 months of his career? This makes no sense.
You messed with the wrong guy today. You really messed with the wrong guy. You want to know why?
Anonymous now, what the hell's going on here? Uh-oh. What the hell is that thing? I don't know what that is, but it doesn't look like Anonymous wants to find out. I mean, there's been a lot of discussions. Oh my god, this is practically a goose chase. Cat and mouse running along.
Run, Bob. Run.
Anonymous has nowhere to go.
So
he might have think. He should have thought twice before attacking Revan from behind. And then, oh, look out. Uh-oh. Anonymous getting the hell out of Dodge. And I don't think he wants anything to do with Revan anymore. He may have had a reason to attack Anonymous 6 months ago, but I think that reason is completely... Oh, wait. Wow. Well, I guess the more you know. And here comes, perhaps, the hottest tag team in the UWE, if not all of BYW, the Theory of Perfection. And they are here to discuss what is heavily rumored to be why they are frustrated with the UWE management. And, well,
I like this music.
Guess we're gonna find out why they're out here after all.
What?
DJ having a seizure?
I'm in a good vibe. I'm good.
Oh no, he's in a good vibe. Well, nonetheless, right. T.O.P, ladies Loose. And gentlemen.
Loose.
Loose.
I don't know about that. let's get to the real reason we're out here.
Witches.
Witches.
Maybe they don't know why they're out here.
Hey, you don't need to see none of that. Rick, I don't have it.
Where out thou, fourth wall?
I don't expect you to have it unless they hand it to you as you were fucking running in.
So why are we out here? Hell's Vacancy!
Ah. Yeah. It was there.
I almost said the wrong CPV, but I had it! Hell's Vacancy, T.O.P., is currently not booked
figures
in any matches whatsoever. Figures. But there's also another person who has always had the word controversy, snarky, straight up ass.
Oh, I think I know who we're talking about.
Everybody knows who I'm talking about.
Yeah.
The self-supremacy, Everett Creed.
Oh boy.
Everett Crede.
Everett Crede. See, throughout all of Everett's career, he's always needed to have somebody by his side. Including me at one point. I was by his side.
Including me?
Including Rick, also. Two people that actually been side to side with Everett Creed.
Sadly.
But it's just the fact that he needs somebody to put him to the top. He can't do it by himself. And that's not insinuating, right? Is that a good word?
Yeah.
Word of the day diction, word of the day calendars. I got it.
Yeah.
Is that me and Rick are T.O.P. We've already said this before. We're not better than each other. We're better together. Without Everett, Everett can't say that he.
Oh no, sorry.
Everett can't say that he is good by himself because he's never been by himself. He's never done anything by himself. So, without further ado, the man of the hour, the self-supremacy bitch, Evercreed.
Further than do?
Further than do.
Further than do? Further
Looks
than
like do. T.O.P. is calling out Evercreed.
And here he comes now, the man that has made a lot of enemies as of late, including Corey Graves, who we assaulted at WrestleCon, and T.O.P. here tonight as they circle Creed with a round of applause. I just wonder why T.O.P. has unfinished business with Creed. I mean, let's not forget Broken Glory when Everett Creed, perhaps that was it. Not only, maybe not when Everett Creed defeated TJ Sakara, but afterwards, Everett Creed broke. I don't even know how to describe it. The Fred Flintstone arm whip with TJ's arm hooked inside the steel chair. Perhaps they're looking for revenge, and this time TJ Sakara is not alone. Everett Creed may have an equalizer with the fire poker, but TJ's equalizer in Rick Rios.
First off.
Oh, here we go.
You.
Yo. Hey.
You. Yeah, you. Hey. Get me a chair.
Hey, you.
Creed talking to TJ.
Yeah, you know I'm talking to your girlfriend. Get me a chair.
Don't get him a chair.
Get him a chair. Get me a chair right now. Come on. Come on.
Yeah! Bring it that way. When I tell you to get me a chair, you get me a chair. You think you're better than me?
I can see where she gets her insubordination from.
Now!
Yeah.
From the winners.
Winners? That's funny you say that, because TJ, don't you remember at Broken Glory, TJ, I beat you?
Do you remember Ultimate Redemption?
Where he beat you?
I remember.
And you didn't win fairly? You had to hit me with a fire poker so the referee couldn't see it? Yeah, that's how you won.
Right.
I'm pretty sure I had you...
I don't have a beard anymore.
Beat.
I'm pretty sure I had a beard.
Look at you two. Look at you two. I feel so sorry for you. Both of you.
I feel sorry for us too, man. We don't have our smoothies today. I'm really not feeling
it. That's a shame. You guys don't have your smoothies. You don't have anything really credible left anymore in backyard wrestling.
You know, yeah.
You guys are so washed up to where...
The best tag team in backyard wrestling history.
The two names that just speak for themselves.
Two of the top names in this league.
It's like you never wanted this, but you did at the same time.
You know what's funny? I just think it's better that we got booked better than he did at WrestleCon.
True!
Better matches, too, actually.
You know, I'm not worried about WrestleCon.
Yeah,
as a matter of fact,
I left
my statement
serious
at WrestleCon, but WrestleCon is not what's important right now. I'll get
done and over with.
Pass is the pass. Let's focus on Hell's Vacancy.
Pass.
Where the reason why we called you out is because...
You want another shot at me? Let me guess.
No, not just me, and not just Rick.
He doesn't want another shot at you. I don't want another shot at you.
T.O.P. would like to have another shot at you.
Proof more that you guys are just a flash in the pan, but also segmentations and symbolism of
ass.
Someone get that dog in the goddamn house before I give him a nightshade as well.
That's... Animal
now,
cruelty.
That's cruelty.
He can get... You know what? I'm going to call
now,
Bart, and I'm going to have him arrested.
Ah, yeah, I got to call Bart. Okay, now look. Look right here. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. You guys want to come out here and make jokes, and this is the best part about it all. You're actually funny. I got to give you that. You guys are hilarious.
I didn't think we were funny at all.
But here's the sad part about it.
I'm actually being serious.
I'm being as serious as I've
here's
ever been in my
career. Here's what's the saddest part of it all, Rick.
Sad.
Rick,
am I about Rick
to cry?
It's just you.
Just me?
He's just talking to you.
Look at you, Rick. You were a former UWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Former UWE.
Yeah, you were. It's so sad. It's so, yeah.
Where were you in that situation?
Oh, where was
former?
I?
I don't even see a former champion
I was
in
front
the, of me.
I was the man that costed you that championship against this guy at Dead Man's Hand.
At least I held the thing, Everett. Come on. I've held it. TJ has held
I've
it.
I've held it.
But have you held it? For all of you watching at home.
Has been on YouTube. Has Everett Creed held the World Heavyweight Championship?
The answer is no.
So that, me and Rick that, don't how even... How does that make you feel? I'm sorry, TJ.
No, yeah.
How does that make you feel? That the two people that you consider a joke around here have more on our resume than you.
Actually, Rick, to tell you the truth, you have the biggest resume.
I know. I'm the only person to hold the regional and the heavyweight title, but that's a different story.
That's what makes us TLP.
That's what makes you guys the theory.
That's
what
TLP.
Look at theory of perfection. That's exactly what you guys are.
You are not a statement of perfection. You're a theory of perfection. And the theory behind it all is that you guys think that you're better than people that are actually better than the both of you. Look at WrestleCon. Look what Big Time Mike did to you.
Did anyone miss the last 5 minutes of my match with
him? Weren't we not talking?
I was beating the living crap out of that pig. But nonetheless, like you said before, we're past WrestleCon now. We're here right now.
Fair enough.
Hell's Vacancy, UWE Lockdown.
That's what you guys are about. It's the 2-on-1 because you can't do it by yourself and you can't do it.
To correct you now, the last thing about WrestleCon, Big Time Mike hit me with the chair first. So the only reason why I got involved in that match was because of him.
Oh dear.
So look out, guys.
He lost to Shabar.
Who was stalling on the ladder for 20 minutes to wait to hit you? Everett, a real competitor would have gotten up and I would have gave him a nice shake for all I would have. But you didn't. You just stood there on.
You think you know everything about me? You think you know what it's like to be Evercreed?
No, that's I just think I'm better than you.
Oh, you think you're better than me?
I know you're better than me. Oh, yeah. You see what I did there?
You know what you guys are? You're nothing more than a bunch of smarks.
He's mad that our shirts are better than his.
Rick.
Nothing.
Word.
Yeah. You guys.
The word?
The word.
The word.
What'd he say?
Oh, the S-M-A-R-K-S. You guys are a bunch of smart.
This move just called me a smart?
This schmuck just called us.
This mother effer.
Rick.
Oh, okay. I could see where this is gonna go.
Hell's Vacancy? Why wait till Hell's Vacancy? We have right now.
We do have.
We're in today.
You know what? You're right.
We're living in the N-O-W.
What is stopping me and Rick from beating your ass right now?
What is stopping you guys from beating my ass is because of the fact that
he can't say that no more.
You see what this is? This is a sleeve, and I got.
Oh, I thought he was pointing to his arm. I was like, that's fat. That's definitely fat.
You guys are really funny again, but like I said, this right here is a sleeve, and right under it is a lot of tricks.
I'm pretty sure this is a sleeve. This is. A better sleeve than
that's a
that
tattoo
piece of shit
sleeve.
Shirt.
Oh, that's always on his skin.
All right, you know what?
Look, it just looks triangles. Yeah, real original Zelda. Yeah, Empire.
So yeah,
what Empire has ever lasted nowadays? Come on.
You know what, guys? I'm getting tired of the jokes now. You guys are saying, oh, you know, you lost the Shibar and all that, because you think you know everything. All right, enough.
I'm still laughing here. This is great, TJ.
Oh, and you guys want to make excuses.
Excuses?
Big Time Mike hit me with the chair first. Greedo shot first. You know what? I don't care anymore.
Facts.
The thing is, T.O.P. is just two pastimers doing what?
Let's just have our own conversation.
They have no other discussion. Hey, no. Look at me when I talk to you.
You focus on the camera. We're focusing on each other.
Hit you back. You want a match? At Hell's Vacancy?
Yeah. No, we just called you out here for no reason. We wanted to say hello to you, Mr. Credit.
How you doing, sir? It's great to see ya. You want a match at Hell's Vacancy? You want T.O.P. versus Evercreed?
Yes.
Just
like three of them.
Yeah,
sure.
You guys are so funny. You know what's even funnier than that? My answer is no. So you guys can stay at the bottom of the pile and work your way up, and then perhaps you can get an opportunity.
We've practically done that in a week.
The name T.O.P. like I said, is not the bottom, it's the top. It spells it out in the goddamn name.
You're gonna get censored for that one.
Goddamn, really?
Look, you know what you guys really are?
Goddamn.
TJ, you know what we really are?
Smarks.
Smarks? I'm waiting for it. What are we really?
Pathetic.
TJ? We're pathetic.
You know what? Goddamn it.
He said it best. You know what? The man never lies.
Why hasn't the bitch got me a chair yet?
What happened? Why?
Get me a chair. Oh.
You know what? It's not my girl.
Here
he is. Rick.
Oh, BT Dubs, this dog shitter around here somewhere.
Now listen.
Wait, hold on. You shouldn't have both sides of the shirt.
Oh, yeah. Let me get it. Now listen. If you don't give us a match at Hell's Vacancy.
He looks scared.
He is very scared.
He looks scared.
If you don't give us a match at Hell's Vacancy, we'll just end you now.
You want a match? You want a match at Hell's Vacancy? You want a match?
You got it.
I just have you pressed up against a fence.
You got it. Your match at Hell's Vacancy.
That's right. Good little dog. Oh, now you might need a little more gel there.
Hold on,
I think we threw him in dog shit because I smell it. It's pretty bad now.
I'm sorry for roughing
it. Yeah, we did throw him in the dog crap.
It's just, I don't like when people
just
call
look, that, there's Ever Creed's career.
I'm sorry.
All the flies around it.
I'm sorry.
Someone stepped in it or something. I hope it's not me.
Okay.
Who landed in the shit?
Probably me. But,
yeah, he did actually.
Listen. Everett. Look at you. A fella.
Well, it looks like Ever Creed's gonna be facing T.O.P. at Hell's Vacancy.
I salute you for not playing our music.
T.O.P. got the best out of Ever Creed this week.
I love you.
And that's what happens when you call T.O.P. pathetic. And I can only imagine what, or more so how, Ever Creed is gonna retaliate in the future. But right now, here comes the man, the icon, the fearful phenom, that'll be facing the Freak Show in his final match at Hell's Vacancy. Daisy, alongside Minister Sherwood.
No.
This contest here is going to be a rematch from Ultimate Redemption. Daisy will be taking on Ustilo. Ustilo now, after getting the last lap, but scorching Dirty DeChico earlier on tonight, and assaulting Jason Atlas last week, Ustilo's got a lot of momentum going into his match at Hell's Vacancy as well. But let's not forget what Daisy has also done. After Jason Atlas was defeated by Lips, Daisy came out after Lips gave Atlas a little pep and faked him out with the pink eye and made the Freak Show flinch. And for the first time ever, we are going to see the Phenom and the Freak Show at Hell's Vacancy in the main event. But right now, we have a rematch from Ultimate Redemption. We have Ustilo going against Daisy.
My contest is scheduled for one fall, and it's Daisy, are you ready?
Where's the fourth fall?
Yeah. Ustilo,
not
are
sure,
you ready?
Sure, Sherwood, I'm not sure.
I like to smile.
Yeah, this should be a really good one, ladies and gentlemen. And talk about the evolution of both characters here. I mean,
ring that bell.
Even from Ultimate Redemption, Ustilo really starting to have a name for himself here in the UWE, and Daisy finally getting what I must say is the respect and the recognition that he deserves. And now this match taking place here. And after this, we also have a special presentation, some footage of some of Backyard Wrestling's icons to discuss the match at Hell's Vacancy between Daisy and Lips. And you can see Daisy just pushing Ustilo there. And here comes Ustilo. Ustilo showing some offensive momentum here, a clothesline. And it looks like, oh, it doesn't look like it had much effect. Ustilo perhaps a little bit shocked that Daisy did not go down on one or two clotheslines. Daisy might be getting fired up for his match against Lips. And that's another thing. These superstars can't focus on their opponents at Hell's Vacancy. They got to focus on their match here tonight, because that's going to determine who has the most momentum going into Hell's Vacancy. And unfortunately, this will be Daisy's final match on UWE Lockdown. So a lot here. Oh, Simone dropped there by Ustilo.
Whoa!
A lot of emotion going into this match, as it is the final match on UWE Lockdown featuring the fearful Phenom.
I gotta have to make sure all you're talking about is
Ustilo now sure targeting the leg of Daisy's. And this doesn't look good now for Daisy. the pyromancer of the UWE. And look out, that flying senton there. Looks like he got it right on the leg. And he's really trying to work on Daisy's leg, trying to ensure that Daisy does not use that pink eye against Ustilo. Ustilo was discussing with how he suffered the pink eye at Ultimate Redemption earlier tonight, when he discussed why he's had this change of heart all of a sudden. And look at that! Ustilo working on the leg of Daisy, and it's going to be very difficult for Daisy to connect with that pink eye, or perhaps even attempt to try to execute it after Ustilo is hyperextending the hamstring.
What do you say, Ustilo? Would you like to quit?
Daisy now wrenching away on Ustilo's leg.
Hey, get off the rope! I didn't think I saw that. I'm a technical
referee. Oh, and now look at this. Ustilo trying to grab the rope, and he's got the ropes.
3, 4.
Ustilo getting the hold of the ropes there. If you haven't noticed, the UWE's back full time with the ropes. Ustilo tried to tip up, but he couldn't with his leg. Daisy was working on Ustilo's leg as much as Ustilo was working on Daisy's.
I didn't even lock it in.
Mr. Sherwood watching on as... And I don't even know... From the past 3 years that Daisy has been alongside Minister Sherwood, I still, to this day, do not know the relationship between Daisy and Minister Sherwood. And this doesn't look good for Ustilo. Ustilo's leg right around the post. Ustilo's in a lot of trouble. And I don't know what the hell Daisy is looking for. Placing Ustilo's leg right by the ring post. Not looking good. Oh my god! Ustilo's leg may have snapped! And now Daisy slowly dissecting Ustilo here. And he may not be done. Kicking Ustilo's leg right into the post. And it looks like Daisy's looking to do more damage to Ustilo. This is something that Lips has got to watch out for at Hell's Vacancy in 2 weeks' time. This doesn't look good for Ustilo. And Ustilo gets his leg out of the way. And now Ustilo all the way Daisy's head going right into the post. And Daisy is out cold. I don't think Daisy has moved since his head was bashed. Referee checking on Daisy. This doesn't look good for Daisy right now. We got to show a replay of how all this transpires. Look at this. Ustilo's leg being shattered, but watch Daisy's head right here. And you can hear Daisy's skull making impact, but it looks like Daisy, during the replay, has got back up on his feet. Ustilo now getting back up, and it looks like he's got Daisy by the and Ustilo!
You gotta stop following with me.
Ustilo with that modified chokeslam cover on Daisy, and Daisy.
Daisy for the last time.
Daisy raking the eyes. Brett's going to some desperate tactics. Trying to blind the pyromancer. The fire fanatic Ustilo. And this doesn't look good. Wow, firing Daisy!
Oh my god!
Daisy's neck may have snapped on the wildfire from Ustilo!
He's choking him!
And that two! And a rope. A far break, I should say. Nonetheless, whether it be a rope break or a bar break, it broke the count. And now Ustilo undoing the wrist tape. Sometimes I've been seeing quite a lot, Ustilo would use that wrestling tape as a... He'd use that as a weapon of choice. Luckily, he doesn't use any incendiary objects. And now Ustilo taking a trip to the outside. Ustilo trying to get back in, and Daisy coming in, stunning Ustilo. And this is not the first time these two have collided. Hell dog on the outside! Not the first time these two have collided, though. They had an amazing match at Ultimate Redemption. Ustilo actually suffered a deaf ear for over 4 hours after the pink eyes that he has received from the fearful phenom!
Eight!
And they gotta get in before a count of 10.
No!
Be a damn shame if Daisy's last match on lockdown ended in a count out, but Daisy broke up the count. And Ustilo clotheslining Daisy from the outside back in. And now Ustilo pounding away.
Shit, that was close. That was still close. Okay. You know, I'm gonna get my seat right.
Fontanic body of
fright.
Getting the shoulder off. Many people have referred Daisy to a flower. There's many phases of the fearful phenom.
They're not telling
in the UWE. Daisy has had many transformations, many evolutions, as you can see. Now in the black. And Daisy setting up. Maybe perhaps for the pink eye. And who's the little cat? Oh my god, what a scorch! What a freaking scorch by Ustilo! And
that's a goddamn slobber left.
I don't know if Ustilo had a Ustilo may not have had him with his shoulders down the first time, and that right there cost Ustilo a huge opportunity. Imagine if Ustilo was able to defeat Daisy here. That would be quite an upset, especially with Daisy having his final match on UWE lockdown here.
Yeah, you sure would switch places.
What do you say? Daisy with his leg scissors now on Ustilo. Ustilo's in a precarious predicament here. Ustilo now grabbing the rope. Daisy's got to let go before five. And now Ustilo fights out. Two. Daisy wants Ustilo back up. I can only imagine.
Oh!
Oh, yeah?
What the hell is Ustilo looking for? That's another scorched.
Let's go, Daisy!
You got it!
Ustilo.
Yeah, Daisy.
Perhaps setting up for the scorched. This doesn't look good. Ustilo may earn the flower here. Oh, the pink eye connects! Oh my God. The pink eye out of nowhere! Daisy beats Ustilo!
I mean, he told you he was going to do it.
Daisy caught Ustilo with the pink eye, and that's exactly what Lips has got to worry about. That Hell's Vacancy. And I'm sure Lips is watching this match. And Daisy has picked off a huge... huge victory here on UWE Lockdown.
Daisy, 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 Daisy.
Daisy having his hands raised by the referee and Minister Sherwood.
Great job!
Ustilo's ass has just been smoking. Uh-oh, look at Daisy.
Another.
Is Daisy perhaps looking to send a message?
Another one.
To his
another
Hell's Vacancy opponent. Ustilo, don't get up. Daisy now, is he gonna... Wow.
Okay.
A sign of respect after the months of animosity. And what a way to go out on UWE lockdown for Daisy. And I'm sure that is an amazing performance that Ustilo will be recognized for as well. You can have no shame if you are Ustilo the Pyromancer. But guys, to wrap it up here on UWE Lockdown, a special presentation based off of this iconic battle that is gonna take place. It is 3 years in the making. It is Lips versus Daisy at Hell's Vacancy. Daisy's final match here in the UWE. And he's going to be facing the man that everybody's been wanting to see him go against for all this time. Perhaps the most controversial superstar in all of UWE, the flamboyant freak show, Lips.
How can you see into like open doors, leading you down into my core,
the thing about Lips is that he's more than just different from the UWE, is that he's different from the entire community of backyard wrestling all over the world, really.
He is that guy that people actually legitimately will not step in the ring with because they're scared of him. And that is something that I think Lips can proudly boast as a huge accomplishment, that he's actually made people legitimately scared to step in the ring with him.
From his attire, which is way out of the ordinary.
He's creepy and he's weird.
Lips is unlike any other person in backyard wrestling. The mind games he plays with his opponents are unlike no one else's. And honestly, I think this is one of the first real challenges that Daisy has ever faced.
He's electrified backyard wrestling, in a way of speaking, because he's so different, he does things so differently, and you never know what you're gonna get. He's just got such a big impact because he's always bringing something new to the table. He's always performing in ways that you can't predict.
There's different styles of backyard and backyard wrestling, gimmick-wise and all that stuff, but I have to say Lips is definitely the one that's most out there and the most creative, honestly, because he is a transsexual demon.
He likes lust. He is gluttonous over anything that he can drag into his lair and do who knows and God knows what, and God forbid he ever shows it on camera.
I've done the kiss, like the little kisses that he blows towards opponents and stuff. It's just, it's freaky. And you know, that's what makes him original.
He is an embodiment of evil. Daisy is a phenom. Whether he's the fearful or feared phenom, he is still that guy that you are going to be scared of, and you don't want to see him gearing up for that pink eye.
With the pink, he was afraid of everything.
Daisy might be the fearful phenom, he might be scared of a lot of things.
Oh, it could have been the freaking music playing and like the big breakdown, and he freaking jumps out of nowhere and starts flipping out.
To take a character who's, you know, he started off as the fearful phenom. I mean, his entire backstory is always being afraid. And fear is another huge part of life in general. And as Daisy's evolved, he's kind of transcended that fear slowly. And he's evolved into so much more.
His kick is the most feared move in backyard wrestling. Whenever you hear about the pink eye, people are legitimately scared that they will get hit with this pink eye and their jaw's gonna get dislocated. And sometimes that's probably the truth.
No one can argue that he is one of the best in backyard wrestling. Everyone loves Daisy for a reason. And the fact that this is his farewell tour, it makes everyone sad because we love the character so much.
And then he went to the purple one, which was at Best in the Yard, facing Zach Daniels.
Best in the Yard, him and Zach Daniels, they stole the show. They did. They were in the middle of the show with no build, and everybody was talking about Daisy by the end of that night. Crazy to think that out of all that star power on that show, Daisy was the one that stood out.
Once you step in the ring with Daisy, you feel fear yourself. Especially when he starts kicking that leg back, because you know there will be a pink eye in the future. You have no chance to get out of it.
Until this dawn. Lips and Daisy, that's a dream match within a company that's been overdue and is definitely gonna clash.
It's Lips versus Daisy. You wanna talk about a match? Let's talk about two of the most iconic characters in backyard wrestling history going at it at Hell's Vacancy.
Let's say this right now, this is like Undertaker facing Kane for the first time. It feels like they're in the Hell in a Cell right now looking at each other and ready to duke it out. Like, it's just seeing all the energy that Daisy has with the aggression and stuff, and then Lips plays the mind factor. When those two things collide, it's just gonna be destruction for whoever's in their path, including for themselves.
I think you get the perfect style clash. Something that people have always wanted to see. And when those two meet, there's no knowing what you're gonna get. And that's what really makes it special.
At Hell's Vacancy, we're gonna see Daisy's last match. And we're gonna see Lips try to burn the flower.
What better way to sum up Daisy's career than an awesome match against Lips and Hell's Vacancy?
Lips versus Daisy at Hell's Vacancy is a match that I've been looking forward to for 2 years. Two men that have never stepped in that ring together until then at Hell's Vacancy, where you will have the Fearful Phenom and the Freak Show finally going head to head, one on one against each other. And we're finally going to get to see who is the better man.
Daisy's going to kill him because you can't kill Daisy.
Liz is going to win.
I'm going to have to give it to Daisy.
I think the one with the higher chance of walking out victorious is Daisy.
I would probably go with Lips just because he has the mind games, the power to take someone off edge of their game plan.
Lips is not walking out the winner there. Daisy is too quick, physically, mentally, and he's got the X factor of Nurse for Sherwood.
I honestly think Lips has this in the landslide. Tell you the truth, no offense to Daisy, no offense to what competitor Daisy is. Lips has that mind that can either make you or break you. And most of the time, it breaks them.
That is going to be a main event for the ages. It's going to be a main event where people are going to be locked in. Their eyes are going to be glued to the screen because this is the first time they have ever faced off.